الحديقة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء ثالثا بأعلى أصواتكم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد
وعلى آل الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين سيما سيدتنا وسيدة نساء العالمين فاطمة الزهراء عليها وعلى أبنائها صلى الله عليك يا أم الأئمة الطاهرين أيتها المظلومة المقهورة. يا ليتنا كنا معكم سادتي فنفوز فوزا عظيما. قال الله العظيم في كتابه الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة. في هذه الليلة الأليمة وهي ذكرى شهادة الصديقة الطاهرة فاطمة الزهراء عليه السلام، أول شيء نعزي إمامنا وسيدنا صاحب العصر والزمان، ونعزي علماء الإسلام كافة، ونعزيكم أيها الأحبة بهذه المناسبة. ونبدأ إن شاء الله في هذا الوقت القليل بالإنجليزي إن شاء الله نبدأ، ثم نختم بالعربي. So we're going to start with our short presentation in English, if you don't mind.
You're the boss.
Thank you. And we will shed some light on the life of Lady of Ladies, Fatima salawatullahi wa salamu alayha. Referring to this ayah, Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned that indeed in the life, لقد كان لكم في رسول الله. In the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you can take a lesson, an example, and you can take him as a role model in your life, and also in his progeny. So that applies to his purified progeny, and one of the most beloved one to Rasulullah is the Sayyida Fatima salamu alayhi. He said, Fatima bar'atun minni. Fatima is a part of my heart. Man adaha faqad adani. First of all, you may ask this question, why we commemorate the event of Fatima Zahra alayhi salam too many times? Because we have three narrations, three riwayat, a hadith. We already commemorated the event, the first riwayah, according to the first narration, last month, in Arabic month, Jamadil Ula. And also we commemorate this event, the second narration, the second event of Sayyidah Fatima alayhi salam, at the beginning of the Arabic lunar month, Jamadil Thani. According to some of the riwayat that she, salawatullah alayha, she died after her father about 90 days. So we have some riwayat 75 days, we have 90 days, we have others. But in general we have two main events of Sayyidah Fatima alayhi salam. And because of the tragedies that she suffered from. And she asked Imam Ali alayhi salam to bury her at night. And that's for elite people, elite companion, not for everyone. It's not a public burial. The burial of Fatima Zahra alayhi salam, it was in a dark of night, it was secret. So that's why we have this difference between hadith and riwayat, and it's very important to commemorate this event, even though three times. It's a barakah, it's a blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal. And you are blessed that you have this tawfiq, you have this ni'mah, you are lucky that you are here tonight. Believe me. May Allah reward you all, inshallah. We have many people, they don't know about Sayyidah Fatima. And they, when they come on that day, the Day of Judgment, they ask Fatima, "Oh Fatima, make the Shafa'ah intercession for us." She asked them, "Where were you on my events?" Unfortunately, especially those who, we don't talk about others, because others, they don't know about Fatima at all. But we as followers, or those who claim that we follow Sayyidah Fatima Zahra alayhi salam, we don't care about these events. Anyway, I don't want to blame you. Alhamdulillah, you are already are here, and your presence is so appreciated by Allah Azza wa Jal. Inshallah, may Allah reward you all. Let me start with this riwayah, this hadith, then I will shed some light on one lesson of the life of Sayyidah Fatima salawatullah alayha. The hadith narrated by Sunni and Shi'i as well. Many Sunni scholars, they say, on the day of resurrection, on the day when the oppressed shall bite their hands, يَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمْ عَلَى يَدَيْهِ, because of regret, يَقُولِ يَا لَيْتَنِ اتَّخَذْتُ, I wish that I spend some hours, I wish to spend some, you know, minutes to learn from the life of Fatima alayhi salam. So when the oppressors shall be gathered in humiliation on that day, so Fatima alayhi salam, she came and a voice comes from the throne, from Allah Azza wa Jal, said, "O people of the gathering, lower your heads and cast your eyes down, for this is Fatima, the daughter of my beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." Fatima proceeding towards paradise, then the call shall come from the throne, the arsh, "My beloved one and the daughter of my beloved one, ask us and you shall be given whatever you wish, O Fatima." Imagine what kind of blessing, what kind of ni'mah, a woman. Those who talk against women in Islam, unfortunately, we have a lot of Muslim and non-Muslim as well, they accuse Islam that Islam belittling women. We have a hadith that the first one who enters paradise is Fatima. Also narrated by Sunni, not by Shia. "So my beloved, ask whatever you wish and intercede. Your intercession shall be accepted by my honor and exaltation. The oppression of no oppressor shall pass my judgment today." Fatima will then say, "O Allah, my progeny, my followers, my Shia, the Shia of my progeny, those who love my followers." See the ni'mah of, and the great status of Fatima on that day. "Those who love me and those who love my progeny and my followers, she will pick her followers, salamullah alayha, and those who love, you know, love them, just like a bird chooses the seeds, the good seeds from the bad seeds. كَمَا يَلْتَقَطُ الطَّيْرَ الْحَبِّ الْجَيِّدْ مِنَ الْحَبِّ الرَّدِيدِ, then she will lead them into paradise. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد.
اللهم صلِّ على محمد وآل محمد.
That's the good news for this night, because alhamdulillah, we don't have doubt that we love Fatima alayhi salam, right? They have doubt? No. But unfortunately, we don't know about Fatima. We have one condition. One condition. Sometimes you see, if you visit Imam Hussein alayhi salam, Allah Ta'ala will give you Jannah, paradise. You may surprise, you may be surprised that how come Allah Azza wa Jal will give me paradise for just spending $2,000 or $3,000? That doesn't make sense. Yes, makes sense. Why? Because there is a condition. عَارِفًا بِحَقِّهِ. If you know this Imam, if you know the this personality, if you know Fatima alayhi salam, and if you act upon her or his life, her personality, this is the ma'rifah. So the one who lies and he said, I love Fatima alayhi salam, of course this is lack of ma'rifah, lack of knowledge about Fatima alayhi salam. Those who cheat others and they say we love Fatima or we visit Fatima, those who commit sins while they are visiting Ahlul Bayt sallallahu alayhim or after they come back home, this is something, a barrier between the ziyarah, between the jannah, between the reward and the prize of Allah Azza wa Jal and this love. So don't think it's easy. No, it's a big challenge, it's a big struggle. That's why we'll come and we will shed some light on this, the lesson of Hayat of the biography of Fatima alayhi salam. The first thing and the foremost, Fatima alayhi salam teaches us, especially women, how to stand up for our rights. That's very important. We all know, maybe a couple of weeks ago, we have heard about Fadak, the issue of Fadak. Or you will know about this, the issue of Fadak. So, if we want to summarize the issue of Fadak, the lesson is how to stand up for your rights, whether you are men or women. Don't say, no problem. If Fatima alayhi salam, she used to ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to make dua, and instead of going out and giving speech in the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa, nobody knows about Fatima and the right of Ali alayhi salam. Nobody knows. So even though she is a great woman, a great lady, nobody can seize Fatima. At that time, when she went from her house, she went with some women, Hashmi women. خرجت في لمة من حفدتها. She didn't expose herself, just we see it nowadays. Unfortunately, we have some Muslim women under this title. So we want to serve Islam. They want to serve Islam according to their conditions, not their Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam conditions. So they expose themselves and they say, we want to be activists in the society. That's not acceptable. But inshallah, we'll talk in Arabic about this issue. But anyway, it's very important to know and to say something, even if you don't see any influence now. Later on, no problem. Fatima alayhi salam, at that time, nobody cares about her. Nobody cares. But now, after 14 centuries, now we are commemorating the event of Fatima and we praise Fatima alayhi salam because of this attitude. See? And many people, believe me, if the American, non-Muslim, if they know about Fatima, believe me, I don't have any doubt they will rush towards Fatima alayhi salam. I mentioned this story. There is a well-known author here in America. His name is Jeffrey Lang, I think you know him. He's one of the professors in mathematics in one of the states in America. He wrote some books about Islamic hypocrisy, converted from Christianity to Islam, and he wrote some books. He mentioned his story. He said, I spent about 10 years, I was so hesitant to accept Islam because he's, you know, he deals with equations, mathematics, you know, he has some rationality. It's not easy to convince such people. He said, I spent 10 years studying Islam. Then I saw a hadith, a riwayah, in one of the Muslim books, Sahih al-Bukhari. He said, I saw this riwayah. الله تعالى ان الله يرضى لرضا فاطمه ويغضب لغضبها. الله تعالى gets angry because of the فاطمه عليه السلام. And he's satisfied because فاطمه عليه السلام is satisfied. I said, wow, in the West, we always think that Muslim are belittling women. Muslim, they humiliate women. So how come Allah Ta'ala, Allah the Lord of this universe, He made a condition of His satisfaction, but just for women? He said, then I accepted Islam because of this hadith. After long years of studying, of course, or searching about the truth. He's an American. He was atheist, of course. So we have this ni'mah, but we don't know. We have this pearl in our hands, believe me. Jawhar. Many people, they say, oh, but we love Fatima, we go to the majalis, but we don't apply the life of Fatima and the lesson of life of Fatima to our life. We don't care about that. So brothers and sisters, especially sisters, the first lesson, how to stand up for your rights, because nobody cares about you. Nobody cares. Now Muslim all over the world, they suffer, you know. They are being accused, they are being, you know, killed everywhere, and nobody cares about them. If you read the newspaper nowadays, if you see the movies and all the media, they accuse Muslim day and night. And many Muslims, they don't care. They don't care about that. They say, okay, what can we do? I'm just one person. You can do a lot. The lesson of Fatima tonight, so what's our responsibility? I have a friend of mine in England. He said once, I called the journalist, and I asked him, why are you accusing Muslim every time in the newspapers, magazines, all these type of media? Why are you accusing Muslims? He said, because when we write something good about Muslims, nobody encourages us. But when we talk badly, or when we accuse some other groups, you know, some minorities in Europe or here, when we talk and we talk something bad against any minority, other non-Muslim, so it's a thousand of emails they send, you know, to me, and they say, why are you doing such, why are you writing this or that? And also when I write something good about them, they praise me. But you Muslims, if I write something good about you, nobody cares. Nobody praises me. And if I write something, you know, an accusation, nobody says why. So, because I'm not talking about you, inshallah you are not careless, but in general, the majority of Muslims here, they are not well aware about the politics here. They don't know. Maybe some of them, they don't read even newspaper at all. They watch, this is, you know, American way of life. They watch basketball every week, every weekend. And that's it. So, Fatima alayhi salam teaches us, if you have rights, try to go and try to say something, and don't fear anyone. She was alone, salamullah alayha. And she was a woman. Usually that time, not here in America in the 21st century. That time, it's very hard for women to give a speech in the masjid. And masjid, imagine Masjid al-Nabawi, means like CNN today. Because all Muslims, they come to the masjid and they see what's going on. So she came, salawatullah alayha, and she gave a long and very, mashallah, fluent speech. And she mentioned the whole ahkam, the rules of Islam in this khutbah. Of course, without paper, just like me. Without paper. See the ilm, the knowledge, the courage of Fatima. And we need to learn from this, the sisters. That is a very important lesson. The Quran, Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned the Quran. About one person, he came from a far place in the village. He said, وَجَاءَ رَجُلٌ مِّنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ يَسْعَى قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اتَّبِعُوا الْمُرْسَلِينَ. اتبعوا من لا يسألكم أجرا وهم مهتدون. So he came and asked people for Islam. He asked them. Also, he was alone. He was one person. He was not living in the side of the city or the town. He was living outside of the, in the suburb. But he said, I'm responsible. I have to say something. Don't say I'm not from Dearborn, so I don't care about them. I'm not from Sterling Heights, so I don't come to the masjid or jama or whatever. You are Muslim and you are responsible. Inshallah, you drive 1 hour. If you can do something good, try to do it before too late. So Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned then that the consequence of this person, that the result of this da'wah, this call, he said, قيل ادخل الجنة. Go to the heaven, to paradise. قيل ادخل الجنة. قال يا ليت قومي يعلمون. I wish that my people, they know about my consequence because of his call, da'wah, the message. So that's why Fatima alayhi salam teaches us how to practice our role in life and how to stand for our rights. Also, the second lesson, and I will conclude with this, inshallah, the hijab, the issue of hijab, does not prevent Fatima alayhi salam from standing up for her right. No. Now we have many sisters and many women, Muslim women, they say, okay, if I wear hijab, maybe they will fire me. If I wear hijab, it's very hard to study. I go to the college or university or school. Okay, they put some excuses. No. MashaAllah, now we have doctors, women, they wear hijab. We have engineers, they wear hijab. We have journalists, they wear hijab. We have pharmacists, everything. They wear hijab. They have this, mashallah, they're proud of their hijab. This is an identity of them. They don't feel shy or that, oh, well, we wear hijab in here and in this society, in this community. So what will people say about us? No, don't care about them. Because they have hijab too, but they don't care. Christianity, they have hijab. Judaism, they have hijab, but they don't care about that. Even in, for example, in the Bible, if you read the Bible, you'll see some religions, they don't allow women to handle the book, the scripture. I remember 3 years ago in Israel, they arrest women, American women, because she used to handle like a Torah on next to the western wall in the Jerusalem. So then some women here in Chicago, they mentioned that in Chicago, some of the newspaper in Chicago, Chicago Tribune, they mentioned this, that why you arrest this woman, because you don't allow her to handle the Torah, the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. In Islam, now we are sitting here, we are studying, you can read the Quran anytime. So there is no problem. So why you feel shy because you wear hijab? No. That's why we have to invite our sisters, our friends, ourselves, that we have to wear this hijab. This is a dignity. This is our identity in this country. Believe me, if you don't have hijab here, you don't have any identity. Nobody cares that you are Muslim or not. Nobody cares about you. But if they see your hijab, immediately they will recognize that you are Muslim. And that's, mashallah, blessing from Allah Azza wa Jal. So, Fatima alayhi salam, she went out with her hijab to the masjid in front of the Muhajireen, the Ansar, old companion of Rasulullah, and she didn't care about all of them. That's the other lesson, and we have, of course, too many lessons of Fatima alayhi salam. But then at the end, Fatima alayhi salam, she knew that people, they will not give her right, Fadak, but she insisted that I have to say something. Then the historian mentioned that when she went to the, went back home, she went to the grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam every day, because she spent about 75 days or 90 days, according to the differences between riwayat. She used to go to the graveyard of Rasulullah and cry. Cry. She took Hassan and Hussein salawatullahi alayhim ajma'in. And she said, "Oh Father, oh Rasulullah, the hand that you used to kiss every day." Rasulullah, she used to kiss the hand of Fatima salawatullahi alayha. She did the honor of Fatima. She, the whole Islam honors women. "Oh Father, the hand that you used to kiss has been beaten, oh Rasulullah. My rib has been beaten. Those people, they attack me. They attack Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam." And she used to say this poetry in Arabic, "Mada ala man shamma turbata ahmadin, alla yashamma mada zamani ghawaliya." The person who smells the sweet fragrance of the grave of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what if he does not smell any other fragrance for a long time to come? صبت علي مصائب لو أنها agonies and anguishes and griefs proud me in such a way that they poured upon days, those would have turned to nights. صبت علي مصائب لو أنها صبت على الأيام صرنا لياليا." Another alim, another scholar, another poet says in his poetry, "Ah, ولست أدري خبر المسمار. I don't know what's going on about the nail. ولست أدري خبر المسمار. سل صدرها خزانة الأسرار." If you want to know, ask her chest that was bleeding because of this nail. سل صدرها خزانة الأسرار, the place of all secrets. فمذرأها يا عصرها عصرا كادت بنفسي أن تذوب حسرا. فأسقطت بنت الهدى وحزنا جنينها ذاك المسمى محسنا. ألا لعنة الله على القوم الظالمين. وسيعلم الذين ظلموا آل محمد أي منقلب ينقلبون. والعاقبة للمتقين. صلوا على محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد.